inverse square law, density of shadows. As you may already know, the closer the light is to your subject, the softer the light. And the further it is from your subject, the harder the light. And this rule stays absolutely true regardless of your light source. But there is one part that it trips people up. Because sometimes when you move the light further back, because of the inverse square law, the light spreads out. What happens is the shadows, they get a little bit of fill. They don't look as dark. And sometimes this confuses people. Here's what you want to remember. The light is still harder when it's further away. If you examine the shadows, the gradient beside the nose is still crisp from shadow to highlight. It's just the fact that the shadows aren't as dense. They're not as dark. But because the shadows aren't dark does not mean that it's soft light. Here we're looking at an example of hard light. It's a bare bulb hitting our subject's face. And we want to take a look and examine some of the features of hard light. But first I'm going to take a shot so you can see what it looks like in my camera. Okay. As you can see looking at this photograph, the shadow cast by the nose is very crisp. There's no gradient between shadow and highlight. It's abrupt. It looks like it's drawn on. And the same thing with the definition of the shadow on the cheek. It's very, very crisp. That's what hard light does. But another thing you'll notice is the specularity. And I never quite understood what this word really means, but if you look at the subject in the photo, do you see the highlights and the textures on her forehead and on her cheek? That's specularity. When you're using a hard light source, it makes the bright parts, the whites, brighter, and the shadows a bit darker and more defined. And so what that does is, in the case of this photograph, it shows texture a little bit more. This is why a lot of people don't use hard light in portraits, because it emphasizes textures, lightness, darkness, as well as color. While many people avoid hard light for portraits, that doesn't mean you can't use it. And I've used it many times when I want to do close-up beauty shots with a lot of texture or create something with really crisp lines. Most of the time, however, people use soft light. So let's take a look at an example of soft light. I switch modifiers to a 3-foot Octobox, which is going to give me much softer light. In later videos, I talk in depth about what you can do to create softer light, including modifiers that give you a soft lighting effect. Now I want to take another photograph, and again, we'll compare the quality of the photo, including the shadows and the highlights. Okay, I have the light in a similar position that gives me the loop shadow on the side of the nose. Taking a look at the shadow in this example, do you see how it's not as crisp, it's not as abrupt? With soft light, there's a more gradual transition area between the shadow and the highlight. And the same thing, while the shadow is still dark, it's still defined, there's just a little bit more of a gradient on that edge from the highlight area of the cheek to the shadow area of the cheek. Now, look at those same areas of the forehead before, where there was a lot of that specularity, a lot of those bright highlights. Now, it's much more even. There aren't the bright textures. And as well, if you look at the skin, overall, the quality of it, it looks a little bit smoother. The hard light emphasizes texture. The soft light reduces the texture. One more place that you can see the difference between the hard light and soft light is the shadow cast underneath the chin. You'll see the same thing. You see a very subtle gradient. Basically, any shadow edge with a hard light will be hard and defined. Anything with a softer light is going to be more gradual. The softer the light, the more gradual that transition.